The Systems page provides a high-level overview of all the servers added to the client. This will display the entire list shown in the Add Systems page, whether they are currently enabled in the client or not. The default information displayed includes the system name, serial number, model number, IP address, connection status, license level, MAC address, subscription information, server version number, and more. Additionally, you may choose to hide or display other columns in this list. To do so, simply right-click one of the column headers and toggle on or off the columns of your choosing. Several of the options in this list, such as description, address, asset tag, and others, are considered metadata fields, which are optionally added by an administrator on the Configure System page under the System tab. Completing these optional metadata fields and displaying them on the system page here allows a user to easily filter for a specific system when many are shown. The filter box near the top of the page will display any systems with a displayed field matching the search text entered. In addition to the filter field, users may click on the column headers to sort the fields below it in ascending or descending order. Using this page, a user may quickly see if any systems are currently disconnected by looking at the connection status column. They may determine from the subscription if any listed systems have an expired subscription, or use the license column to determine what level of features are supported. The licensed camera column will indicate if the system has unused camera licenses, which may help an administrator determine if they can reasonably add another camera to the system. The status column will display an alarm status if any of the system triggers have been activated. This does not necessarily mean there is a problem with the system. Right-clicking on the alarm status will display a list of triggered events. In this case, a camera is currently detecting motion, and we see that an input trigger on a device was activated. Towards the bottom left-hand corner of this page, you will find Import License and Export License buttons. Using the Export License button, you may save a CSV file containing the system list with the license key string. An administrator wishing to update several system licenses at once may edit this file accordingly to enter newer license keys in the appropriate rows. Saving the file and then using the Import Licenses button rather than navigating to each system's configuration screen to update the licenses individually. To export a list of all the displayed fields in the list above, you may select the Export button in the bottom right of the page. This too will export a CSV file, but will contain only those fields currently displayed and the information currently reported. Hiding and displaying optional columns in the list allows a user to export customized lists for management records. Lastly, the Connect All and Disconnect All buttons provide a quick way to enable or disable client connections to all listed systems at once.